As y'all can see, y'all know what time it is. Y'all know what we doing today. Hold on, my bad. But I want to start this video out. This is Stop Complicating Entrepreneurship Part 5, man. Part mother in 5. We're going to try not to cuss too much on this one. But I first want to start out by shouting out my dude Kickflip. Shout out to my dude Kickflip, K1, and then Kickflip. Shout out to you, bro, for leaving a positive comment underneath my video. I'm never gonna highlight the negative comments because I don't care about them, but I want to highlight the positive comments before we get too big to where I can't address all of them, and I'll have to just address people kind of in mass. But now we can just singularly kind of address people. And then my dude Midget Lad 968 as well too, forgot to shout you out earlier for leaving another positive comment on my video. Shout out to you, brothers. I want to help everybody I can and build a community. Kickflip, Midget Lad, let me know if there's more stuff that you want to see. Even get at me personally if there's any resources or any way that I can help you. Want to help out my people, want to build a community, you know, and just keep continuing to live out what I was put on this earth to do, and that's to lead people, and not only lead people to God, but also, you know, lead people in entrepreneurship and anything else that I'm doing. So I appreciate you, brothers, and God bless you, brothers, for, like I said, leaving a wonderful comment underneath my video. Really appreciate you, brothers. And for everybody else that's watching right now, anybody liking, or even if you're not liking, even if you're just watching it, appreciate y'all. And like, comment, subscribe, like the video, put a comment under it if you're getting some value from this stuff that I'm putting out. Just continue to put under the comments, let me know what you guys would want to see. But this one, stop complicating entrepreneurship part 5, excuse me, we're gonna talk about company culture a little bit, and it'll piggyback off of what I was talking about with employees. So this will kind of piggyback off everything and encompass it. We're gonna go in here, we got a new client today, so we're gonna work on the new client, beautiful home, get that knocked out. We're gonna run some flyers today too, but we'll talk about company culture today. So that's what we got coming up and Stop Complicating Entrepreneurship part 5. Shout out to all the supporters, Kickflip, Midget Lad 968, other people that have been leaving comments underneath the videos, and other people that just support me in general. Give me a like, comment, subscribe. Peace. Bang. So from a smiling face, and I can see so much clearer.
I can see clearly now the rain is gone. I ain't gotta hurt no more. I can't hear my haters now that I am grown. That hating don't work no more. So much money now, it soothes my soul. I don't need to borrow your dough. Same chick that was laughing at me, now she's choosing role. I bet I can even borrow your hoe. Homie, I'm the same one that was sleeping on the corner. Same one that was eating on the corner. Same one that was praying to God. But I really thank the good Lord for making it hard. I appreciate the struggle, baby, cause it made a young nigga wanna hustle, baby.
I didn't record a lot inside the home. That shit kicked my ass. Woo, that clean day whooped my ass. But we got it done. God is good. Shout out to Ishmael, who I've got a connection with, who then referred me to his family, and that's his family's house that we just cleaned. So God is good. Shout out to Ishmael, and shout out to God. Thank you, God, for all the opportunities that keep just coming down the pipeline, man. Keep coming down the pipe. So, like I said, Stop Complicating Entrepreneurship part motherfucking 5. Part 5. Not gonna cuss too much because I'm about to go read that devotional as soon as I get finished up here. So I'm not trying to cuss too much. But anyway, so now we're gonna talk about company culture. That kind of piggybacks off how you treat the people that work with you. Remember, we don't call them employees, call them the people that work with you, not for you, the people that work with you. And then that ties into company culture. So Cody asked me a great question when he came in. He said, Zach, can I rock the beanie walking inside or not? I said, maybe not this time because it's first impression, but every time going forward, you can do whatever you want to do. It's a beautiful example. You don't want to be like these punk-ass jobs, even that you may be working at right now. You don't want to be like these punk-ass jobs that box you in. They don't let you have any creativity. They don't let you have any personality or let you be yourself. Cody wore some damn polo pajama pants a couple days ago. It's cold outside. I'm not going to be like, no, Cody, you can't wear that. You have to wear slacks and tights. And I'm not going to say any of that. I'm not going to do that because we have a good company culture. So I let people be themselves. You let people be themselves. You let people wear what they want to wear. Obviously, like I said, you have a couple things that you want to follow. Your mission statement.
your overall spirit that you have as a as the owner of the company or as the creator of the company, all of you guys, the spirit that you guys have, you want to instill that. And you also want to have a couple things like, yeah, of course, like we got to wear something that says VBA cleaning services. And don't think that shit is corny. Don't think, I used to think that stuff was so corny, like company parties and Christmas parties and employees dressing up on Halloween and having different days. You don't want to kill that. If you kill that, your fucking company gets killed. Then everybody dreads coming to work. You don't want your company that you're creating, you don't want people to dread coming to that shit. You just don't want that. Then there's no energy, there's no spirit in the company. So you want to have days like that. And we're even working on that ourselves. Another thing that also helps me and Cody out tremendously, we played on the same ball team. Played on the same ball team growing up. All of this stuff relates, man. Sports really relates to business as well, too. You want to communicate. That's a big thing with culture. You want to communicate. And like I said, related back to sports, me and Cody can communicate. We can read off each other. Just like football, reading defenses, reading different things. We can read off each other. I can see if Cody's going upstairs, he knows to maybe vacuum a certain spot before I get in there so that I can clean it more fast and efficiently. It's all about teamwork, effectiveness, and communication. You can relate this stuff even back to sports. So if you play sports, take some of that stuff you learned from playing sports when you were a kid or when you're in high school. Take some of that stuff, apply it to the business, apply it to the company. You know what I mean? You celebrate when your teammates are doing good. You celebrate, you know? You talk to each other. If you got things you need to work on, you communicate. You make things easier for each other. If you're reading defense, say, Cody, hit that slant because this dude's playing up, so hit that slant route. It's all the same thing in basketball, same thing, pick and roll call. It's all the same thing. You want to communicate, and just – that overall, like I said, sports really goes into having a good company culture. So if you've ever played sports, any kind of organized sports, you can take that and apply it. Same shit. Same thing, you can apply it. Don't want to do too much rambling. This is a little bit of a shorter one because, like I said, it just kind of goes off company culture. For us specifically, our culture is of love, man. We want to treat each other like family. We want to treat each other like brothers and sisters. We want to look out for each other. We want to care about each other, ask each other if we're doing all right, help to make each other's job easier. Cody just asked me when I was, you know, taking a longer time. He said, Zach, can I help you clean the bathroom? Can I help you clean these mirrors up? That's all culture, man. That's all company culture. And some of these, your punk ass job you're working at right now, then people may not want to help you. They may see you struggling. They're just like, he's got it. Fuck them. They don't care about you. They're not worrying about what you're doing. We don't do that over here. And you shouldn't do that with your company either. You want to help people out, communicate, and don't take the fire and the spirit out. Let people have fun, man. We have headphones in our ears sometimes. You know what I mean? Listen to music. Get us through. That's something that we do. We communicate with each other and we laugh and joke during the clean sometimes. It's all a part of company culture, man. And we're still working on it. Like I said, we've only got 3 people right now. But as we continue to expand, you'll see the company parties. You'll see the random Tuesday where Zach fucking shows up and brings the employees fucking donuts and shit like that when they're working, or brings them a nice hot meal from out of the Gastonell kitchen or something like that, or brings them some refreshments, some coconut water and stuff like that. Now that's a whole other elevated tip that we'll get into, because your boss ain't doing that. Your boss ain't bringing you no damn coconut water when you're getting ready to get done with your shift or working in that damn cubicle. That's a whole another thing, but we're gonna get into that. Company Christmas parties, Halloween parties, Valentine's Day, all that stuff, bro. All that stuff. End of the year bonuses. Like I said, big Christmas parties and stuff. You want to treat everybody like family. Like I said, company culture and and people that work for you, it all ties in. That's how this video kind of feeds off the next one. So without doing too much rambling, that's going to basically end the video, man. Company culture. You want to have a good company culture. Treat people like family. For us, like I said, our culture is working hard, caring for one another, loving one another, treating each other like family, communicating, making the job easier for one another, and really just giving a fuck about each other, man. That's company culture. Company culture, you can really dumb it down to spirit. It's the spirit that your company has. If you got a shitty spirit, if you got shitty energy, if you're not checking after your people, you're not caring about them, you're not going above and beyond, you're not having fun, your spirit's going to be low. Your culture's going to be low. People are going to go into the job and they're going to fucking hate it. They're going to be trying to pass the time. That's where you got motherfuckers. I used to be a young dickhead kid getting high in the bathroom and shit like that, trying to pass the time away and stuff like that. You don't want that. You want people that are really there to work and that give a fuck about the mission and give a fuck about what you're trying to complete. For us, our mission statement, cleaner world, one home at a time. That's our mission. So we're trying to bring a cleaner world, a cleaner atmosphere, a cleaner world, starting one home at a time. That's a mission statement. You could dumb it down. It doesn't have to be too fucking complex. You hear these motherfuckers, you gotta come up with your mission statement. You gotta have a good mission statement. Look, man, a mission statement can be as simple as what I just said. And company culture, it's as easy as treat people good, have good energy, let people have fun, let people be themselves, let people have their own personality. Simple as that. Don't be a fucking, don't try to be bigger than anybody. Don't make the shit boring. Don't try to be some over-domineering boss and shit. That's basically it, man. Stop complicating entrepreneurship. Part 5. Shout out to all the people that left good comments. Like I said, if you want me to cover something else, if it's something I don't know about, I'll let you guys know, hey, I'm still learning. Even with the company culture, we're still establishing. I've only got 2 people that I'm working with that are my teammates right now. Throughout the course of this year, holy fuck, I've hired probably about 10 to 15 people throughout the course of this year. Man, it's been a roller coaster. But now we got a good, solid team right now. So there's still even stuff I'm learning about company culture. But if there's anything that you want to see from me in the next video, any questions that you got for me, any resources that I can give to you, hit me up. Let a brother know. Stop complicating entrepreneurship. Part 5. Peace.